What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial. So we have successfully completed 5 series of the Android app development tutorial. So this is time for a break. So I will show you guys some of the best Android Studio tweaks. So without any further ado, let me open the Android Studio. I'm opening the first application of our project in the Android Studio. So now you can see the interface is a little more smaller than the phones in the main activity, and activity underscore main.xml file is really smaller, which make a little more hard for our eyes to read. And the all over Android Studio interface is a bright screen that causes eye pain. So likewise, I have already discussed about changing the Android Studio theme. Once again, I'm repeating it. And also today I will show you some of the best tweaks that you can do with the Android Studio. So without any further ado, let's get started into the number one. So in order to increase the size of the text in the main activity and many other places, all you have to do is just go to the file. Now click on the settings. And from the settings, you have to select the appearance and behavior. Now go to the appearance. As I have done before, you can change the theme by clicking on the IntelliJ to Dracula. When you select the Dracula, you can see the Android Studio totally changed it into a black or dark background, which make it a little more easy for the users to use Android Studio for a longer time. So for this instance, I will always go with the IntelliJ, but in your personal condition, you can always select the Dracula. I'm pressing the apply. So the second thing is that you can increase the font size by simply typing for size. And now you have to select the key map. And now you can see under the editor actions, we have 3 options. So all you have to do is right click on the decrease, and you have to add a keyboard shortcut. I want to add the keyboard shortcut as shift plus addition key or the plus key on the number pad. So I have chosen shift plus plus or the addition key. Now click the that's font decrease, so I'm choosing the shift plus subtraction or minus or whatever else you want to call it. And once you have done, I always suggest going with this the same as my settings, because some of the keys that you may always use is already taken by the Android Studio for a particular purpose. So for example, when I type for shift F10, you can see it is already assigned for running the Android app in a live device. So likewise, I always suggest going with the shift plus minus or subtraction. So once you have selected, click the OK, right click on the increase, again add shift plus addition key on the number pad. Okay, reset. I use the reset as shift plus the star or asterisk, whatever else, you can choose that thing on the number pad again. Now click OK, and finally you have to click on the apply. Okay, so once you have applied, click on the OK. So let's give a try of our keyboard shortcuts that we have just assigned now. When I press shift plus addition, can see, wow, it's increasing the font size of the main activity. And when I press shift plus subtraction key or the minus key, you can see it decreasing the size. So likewise, you can always experiment with this condition. So now you can see the font size is increased. Now I'm pressing the shift plus star or asterisk or whatever else again. So when I press that, you can see it resetted the font size into the normal, again increasing. I think that this is better for the video tutorials. You can always choose a bigger size that can reduces the eye pain. Once again, eye is the most important part of doing an Android Studio project. So because if you have no eyes, there is nothing else. That make no sense at all. Okay. So okay, back again. Now let's move to the second part, which is increasing the Android Studio layout screen and some of other things. So the first thing that you can do is reduce the size of this taskbar. For that, right click on the taskbar, go to the properties. Now you can choose use small taskbar from here. You can check that and click the apply, and finally you can press the OK. So now then you will be getting a really smaller taskbar, and this is possible in Windows 7, 8, 8.1 and 10. Okay, so once you have done, you can go to the view from here. Now you can choose the entire full screen, and now you can see Android Studio is on the full screen. It hides the taskbar and the title bar. Tabs are even hidden, and they are able to get back when we are moving the mouse to the top. Okay, so now you can see we got a full screen Android Studio view. Now let's go and check that out. It increased the zooming size into 35 from 33. Let's go, we can. Now let's go to the text. Try changing the text size. Wow, it's still working perfect. If you want to increase the full screen level of your Android Studio, no matter what you want, let's go to that view again and click on the enter distraction free mode. Now you can see everything is more than what we have expected. Again, let's go view enter presentation mode. Wow. So this is the maximum of what you can do with the Android Studio. So you might be wondering that how you can switch between the main activity or the class files and the XML files. So in that case, you can simply press Control Tab on the keyboard, which will pop up the switcher. By keep pressing the Control, you can press the Tab to move from one item to another. Now let's go to the main activity.java, and you can see here it is. So if you want to exit all the things that we have done in the view, you can simply move your mouse over here. It will bring up the tabs. You can choose the view from here. Again, exit full screen, exit distraction free mode, and finally exit presentation mode. So again, increasing the font size. Okay, so that's for now. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial. If you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Peace out.